present, no, a request for that contempt to be lifted, but of course, unless until Ms. Taberna will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in all questions that will be raised by this, by the members of this committee, edi pwede i-lift yung contempt order, Mr. Chairman.
Pag isabi na sa amin ngayon, you can now relate that story now.
Meron kang bank account, di ba?
Meron po.
Meron kang bank account. Meron ka rin cheque. Meron kang cheque. You're under oath, tatandaan mo ha. Meron kang cheque. Ilang cheque na na-issue mo mula na maging corporate secretary ka?
Hindi ko na po matanda.
Marami ka na na-issue ng mga cheque.
Yes po.
Di ba?
Yes.
Ano ang pinakamalaking in-issue mong cheque? Pinakamalaking in-issue mong cheque, how much?
Nasa 500,000.
500,000. Yes. And your salary is only 17,000. At na-increase ka, dumating yun sa 23,000. Am I right?
Yes po.
How can you issue a 500,000 pesos sa isang cheque lamang, correct?
There are other resource persons that the committee has invited for today's scheduled hearing. So we'd like to hear from Congresswoman Jinky Luistro. You are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I wish to address this question to Chairperson Dan Fernandez and Chairperson Antonio Ferrer. This is dated July 23, 2024. In this letter, Mayor, you brought to the attention of the Joint Committee the baseless and malicious accusations that are being imputed against profiting from POGO operations, allegedly receiving 5 million pesos monthly, owning luxurious cars and mansions, all of this from illegal gambling operation. Can you please enlighten us?
Well, is here Secretary Reggie Velasco. Yes, please respond, Mayor Capin.
Yes, Your Honor, Madam Chair. I categorically deny their accusation.
Oh, where did he find all these baseless and malicious accusations?
Through their vlog, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, before we proceed, may we know if Mayor Capel has taken his oath? Yung baseless and malicious accusations ni Napaira Lucas at Toto Causing.
Aba, sila po ay mga vlogger, Your Honor. Kaya, although yung case po kay Ms. Pyra Lucas, na-file na po namin sa Piskalya, kaya according to my lawyer, may sub...
Existence of the allegation as contained in your letter, we will not be commenting on the judicial proceedings that are pending before the court, the one you said, sub judice. If I may proceed, Mr. Chair... I remember that because of this letter, we moved to invite Pyra Lucas and Toto Causing.
Message? That's Pyra Lucas and Toto. Si ano po ba? Si ma'am, kayo muna o si Toto Causing?
Ay, Mr. Chairman, dito lang kami, wala naman na kaming hinanda na speech or introductory statement. We are only here to answer whatever questions that the good Congresswoman Luistro would ask.
Yung isa, 2015, at meron po silang business permit sa amin sa munisipyo, but they insisted na sa akin daw po yun, kaya wala pong katotohanan yun, Your Honor.
Sir, can you reply on that?
Ako po ba, sir?
Yes, kindly reply, Mr. Causing.
Chairman, hindi ko lang maintindihan ko ano alin ang tatarong yung tungkol sa dalawang issue kasi dito eh. Yung issue tungkol doon sa 5 million a month daw at saka yung issue tungkol sa dalawang condotel. So alin ang una pong ano? Kasi sinasabi niya po na baseless. Ngayon, kung ang opinion ko sa dalawa sa akusasyon niya una sa 5 million a month, wala po akong sinabi sa vlog ko na 5 million a month. Ngayon, pagdating naman po sa condotel, binlog ko na rin po yan na condotel na ayon sa informante ko, nasa kanya yan. Kaya tinatayuan po namin ito, Your Honors, na totoo po ang amin nakuha na si kinwento ng aming tinatawag na informante. But of course, iyan ang sinabi ng informant ko sa akin. At ang isa sa mga informante ko dito ay nag-identify niya sa sarili niya as isa siya sa malapit na katira, malapit doon. At kinwento nga rin, nung pinapagawa yan, renovation, ay kinikwento na nagyabang pa nga si Mayor na siya na may-ari nun. Patungkol naman ata, I just do not know how it happened na nagsalita siya na may 5 million a month na sinabi. Ang sinabi ko, nakakakuha siya ng pera. At ang basihan ko po, Mr. Chairman, ay yung statement nila na binigay sa Senate na 10,000 lamang po kada taon ang kinukuha nila na property tax or real property tax o di ka amilyar mula sa mga property ng Puko. So, at sa business tax o mayor's permit, sinabi nila, sila mismo sabi na 4,000 lamang kada taon. So, doon ko po binasi ang aking logical conclusion at kinuwenta ko ang maaring magiging property tax ng 46 o 43 buildings at binasi ko rin po sa inamin ng engineer nila na nag-submit ang nagpatayo o Whirlwind o di kaya Royal South, Lucky South 99 ng bills of materials na umaabot sa 1 billion 70 million. At kung ganun ang materials cost, ibig sabihin po, bilang civil engineer din ako, na sa ngayon, ang estimated labor cost din po ay almost the same sa materials cost. So kung kwentahin mo, ibig sabihin po, ang most reasonable fair market value ng malahat ng building ay 2 billion. Ngayon, pagkakwenta, paano mo kwentahin ngayon ang real property tax? So kukunin muna ang fair market value which is 2 billion, then multiply it with assessment level na binigay ng batas which is 50% para sa mga commercial. Tapos, i-multiply mo, di magiging 1 billion. Pagkatapos, kukunin ang real property tax is equals to 1% times assessed value. So, assessed value is 1 billion times 1%, that is 10 million a year. Tapos, ang lupa pa, sabihin na lang natin na 5,000 per square meter. Ang kinikwenta ko, pag 5,000 per square meter sa 10 hektarya, abot mo ng mga, abot sa 500 million. So, kung kukunin mo po yung tinatawag na assessed value, that is 250 million. At kung kwentahin mo po yung real property tax niya based on assessed value, which is 1%, that is also 2,500,000. So if that is so, ang tinatago na pera mula sana sa property tax at saka sa business taxes ay umaabot mahigit 12 billion. Yun na po ang sinabi ko po.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, kasi may nabasa ako dito from Mayor Capili, you know, that Mayor JBC Capili has a house and lot worth 50 million near the Porac Pogo site. Saan galing itong statement na to?
Sa kanila po, nung una yun yung claim nila. Kaya sinabi ko, pag may nakita sila na bahay ko kahit worth 1 million lang sa kanila na, pero wala naman silang nakita. Then, yung condo na naman, pag nakita po nila, nasa akin po yun, sa kanila rin, I will sign an affidavit pag nakita po nila na nasa akin. Sa kanila na rin po para may pagkita po na talagang wala tayong tinatago kasi napakabilis po nilang magsabi na meron kang ganito pero pag nakita naman nila na wala parang wala lang sa kanila pero nasira na po yung pangalan mo. Una sabi nila sa akin daw yung lupa ng Pogo nung nakita naman na hindi sa akin, hindi man sila nag-apologize. Yung problem po sa lupa, 2017 may court decision na, 2019 pa lang ako naupo, kine-claim din na ako yung kasabwat doon, 2019 pa lang po ako naupo. Kaya, I don't know kung ano po ang may galit po ba sila sa akin para sirain nila ako ng ganito. Sana po, kasi po ako'y halal din ng taong bayan at syempre, I have to protect my leadership then as the mayor na hindi po pwede na sirain mo na lang ang isang tao without any proof paano po ang aking pagkatao, Your Honor. Thank you.
Is this true, Toto Kausing, that you have mentioned the 50 million pesos worth of house and lot in the property that he mentioned. And as well, kasi nakasulat dito mga luxury cars that binili na ni Mayor Capili. Totoo po ba na nasabi niyo po yun?
Mr. Chairman, mga sinabi ko rin sa vlogging ko na yung dalawang kondo, yun ang tinuturo nun sa 50 million na estimate lang yun yung presyo ng buildings na yun. At with regard to the sports cars, sinabi rin po yun sa akin na informant ko. So ang sports car na sinabi sa akin na informant ko, meron siyang BMW, meron siyang meron siyang Porsche, at meron din siyang luxury car na Toyota Land Cruiser na may bulletproof. So yan po ang aking mga sinabi sa akin ng informante ko. Well, if he denies it, then that is also his right to deny. Pero sa amin naman po bilang vlogger, ay umaasa kami sa mga informante na nagbibigay po sa amin ng information, at binabase ko rin sa katotohanan pagkatapos ko manood sa mga Senate hearings na kung saan ay maraming butas ang kanyang mga kinikwento. So kapanipaniwala po ang binigay sa akin ng aking informante. Ganun lamang po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair?
Yes,
I wish to invite the attention of Toto Kausing. You are being challenged by Mayor Capil. I understand and I do not discount the fact that iba yung beneficial owner, iba yung registered owner. But if you have proof to show na mayroon talagang pag-aaring condotel, luxury car, armored vehicle, just like what you are saying today, I hope you can show proof. Because the mayor has challenged you already. Pag may napatunayan ka daw, ibibigay na niya sa'yo. That is for the manifestation, Your Honor.
May I answer now? Sige, anyway, ganito po yan, Mr. Chairman. Yung kwento sa akin, kinlaro ko yung kwento sa akin ng aking informante. So, meaning to say, I do not have any evidence to say, to show that it was his or whatever, but I only...
Mr. Chair, with all due respect, but I wish to interrupt Toto Kausing. This is an inquiry in aid of legislation. We do not allow hearsay evidence. We do not allow testimony if the declarant has no personal knowledge. So until and unless Toto Kausing has personal knowledge of all the accusations against Mayor Capil, I think we need to come up with a resolution on whether to allow him to continue attending our hearing. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes, we take note of the observation of the committee that it seems that the statement of Mr. Kausing are all hearsay and he has no personal knowledge about the issues at hand. And in that case, I would like to ask you from refraining to continue replying to the questions raised by Congresswoman Luistro. In this case, at the moment, Chairman Dan Fernandez also has a question to Ms.
No, I really don't have a question right now, Mr. Chairman, but it seems that it's already 5 o'clock. And we have invited so many resource speakers on today's hearing, but unfortunately, it's getting already late in the afternoon. So our apology, you know, by me, Mr. Chairman, no? Because we have invited yung mga sa PNP, and we were not able to discuss the issue of the unsolved killings in Central Luzon. We will be discussing that in the next hearing, Mr. Chairman. And as well, the issue on those incorporators that we have invited. The Lucky South 99, the Sunyu one. They did not attend. And we issued already the show cause order. And hopefully in the next hearing, they will be attending on our Quadcom. And also the motion for reconsideration of Ms. Ronaldin Baterna, who was cited in contempt on August 7, 2024. And order detained in the house premises for 30 days. There was a motion for reconsideration, and I believe, Mr. Chairman, that we need to have a discussion with this person. So I don't know what's the pleasure of the body with regards to her temporary detention in the House of Representatives. And lastly, Mr. Chairman, we have invited also the anti-money laundering, the Department of Foreign Affairs, NBI, the PIDEA, the Bureau of Immigration, BIR, SEC, the PAOCTF, Anti-Money Laundering Council, and a lot of the department heads that have attended in this Quadcom. But we were never given the opportunity na matanong po natin sila. So, Mr. Chairman, our apology. And I hope that we can invite them again in the next hearing. So,
Mr. Chair, on
questions.
Am I recognized?
Yes, after are you done, Chairman?
Yes, I'm done, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Mr. Chair, for Ms. Baterna, I understand that she has filed a reconsideration about the contempt and detention order. But I respectfully manifest, Mr. Chair, that there are witnesses already who executed affidavits in possession of the PAOK establishing her connection with Lucky South 99. That is a manifestation.
Okay, and the information was shared to you by the PAOK?
Mr. Chair, I have copy of the affidavits. Reason why I earlier moved for the invitation of the four witnesses which are with the PAOK, Mr. Chair.
Okay, since is that an objection to the request for reconsideration by Ms. Baterna?
Yeah, wag muna. Chairman?
Yes, is that an objection?
It is a manifestation, Mr. Chair, because I understand she is our only link to Lucky South 99. Kasi Ong is nowhere to be found. The resource speakers attending in our hearing refuse to acknowledge their connection to Lucky South. And I lament that in our today's hearing, most of the resource speakers in Pogo controversy did not appear. So, Mr. Chair, I want to bring to the attention of the Quadcom that Ms. Baterna is our only link to Lucky South 99. But I, of course, submit to the wisdom of the Honorable Chairs.
Okay. The manifestation of Congresswoman Jinky Luistro seems to be an objection to the request of Ms. Baterna for a reconsideration that she requested the committee to be released from detention. But I guess the pleasure... What is the pleasure of the body?
Mr. Chair, considering the manifestation of Congresswoman Luistro, and I have a lot of questions as well to the person of Ronalina Baterna. And I hope that she still stays in the premises of the House of Representatives. In all reality, the manifestation of Congressman Luistro makes sense. And she's the only link doon po sa mga iniimbestigahan nating mga incorporators. And as a matter of fact, Mr. Chairman, we have invited all the incorporators of those corporations and they did not attend on today's hearing. What more, if we will be allowing her to be out of our jurisdiction. And so I support the manifestation of Congressman Luistro.
So can somebody put that into motion so that the committee can rule on the objections of both Congresswoman Luistro and Congressman Fernandez?
Mr. Chair,
Chairman Ako,
maybe it would be wise for us to consult the member of the committee who moved for the to file or to move for the contempt of Ms. Ronaline Taberna or Baterna, and that guy is the Honorable Chairman Paduano. So maybe ask his opinion.
Kaya nga, Mr. Chair, kanina pa ako gusto magsalita eh, because I was the one who moved to cite her in contempt. Now, Mr. Chairman, ganito lang po. He was cited in contempt based on violation of paragraph C of our internal rules, section 11. Now, of course, I do believe that he, as of now, she's only the person or the witness linked to Lucky South 999. But still, Mr. Chairman, the process with regards to contempt and she sent a request for the contempt to be lifted. But of course, unless until Ms. Taberna will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in all questions that will be raised by this, by the members of this committee, and if pwede lift yung contempt order, Mr. Chairman. Now, ang question ang we're running out of time. And a lot of members wants to ask questions for Ms. Taberna to prove that indeed he will tell the truth. Now, Mr. Chairman, that's why, since we have no sufficient time in today's hearing, I joined the motion manifestation of Congressman Luistro. Yeah, I joined your manifestation. I don't need a motion because that is just a motion for recon. Now, I joined the manifestation of the good vice chairperson of public accounts, Mr. Chairman, that we, as of now,
we will not lift the contempt order and detention order for Ms. Baterna, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. So, the statement made by Congressman Paduano likewise seems to be an objection to the request for a motion for recon. So in that case, the chair still awaits for a motion so that we can rule on whether we will consider the request of Ms. Baterna. Is there any motion? The parliamentary status, Your Honors, is that the chair still awaits if there will be a motion to consider the request of Ms. Ronaline Baterna for a reconsideration on her detention in the House of Representatives. Since there are no motion, and it seems that we do not have a quorum. And under our rules, we have to establish a quorum in each of the four committees in the Quadcom. Therefore, we cannot rule on her request. And being so, Ronaline Baterna will still be detained in the premises of the House of Representatives.
Mr. Chairman,
Congressman Fernandez and then Congressman Abante.
Have we actually asked Ms. Baterna if she is now willing to tell the truth? Have we asked her? Why don't we ask her now if she's willing to tell the truth so we will be able to talk about her request, Mr. Chair? Because if she will not, if she will still insist that she will not tell us what we need to know, then, of course, I will even make a motion not to lift the motion of Congressman Baterna.
Okay, Ms. Baterna, narinig mo yung sinabi ni Congressman Abante?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair. Pwede pong paulit.
Sinasabi ni Chairman Abante na kung ikaw ba ay willing magsalita ng katotohanan at pawang katotohanan lamang.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Okay, so why don't you spill out the beans now? Sabihin mo na talaga ang katotohanan ngayon para mapag-usapan namin yung motion sa'yo. Yung reconsideration. Pakisabi na sa amin ngayon. You can now relate that story now.
Mr. Chair, good afternoon po. Hindi ko po talaga totoong trabaho yung corporate secretary. Yung totoong trabaho ko po doon is sa gate pass lang po. Nag-i-issue lang po ako ng gate pass sa may main gate.
Mr. Chair. Para mapabilis po tayo.
With the indulgence of Chairman Abante, because Chairman Abante has the floor. Is that okay,
Chairman? Mr. Chair, I think it's already 5 p.m. And we need to go back to Manila. Isa na nagtatanong ko sa iyo, Ronaline. Ronaline, meron kang bank account, di ba?
Meron po.
Meron kang bank account. Meron ka rin cheque.
Meron
kang cheque. You're under oath, tatandaan mo ha. Meron kang cheque. Ilang cheque na na-issue mo mula na maging corporate secretary ka?
Hindi ko na po matanda.
Marami ka na na-issue ng mga cheque.
Yes po.
Di ba?
Yes,
ano ang pinakamalaking na-issue mong cheque? Pinakamalaking na-issue mong cheque, how much?
Nasa 500,000.
500,000?
Yes.
And you are, your salary is only 17,000. At na-increase ka, dumating yun sa 23,000. Am I right?
Yes po.
How can you issue 500,000 pesos sa isang cheque lamang, correct? Di ba? Isa pa lamang. Ilang cheque ang inisyo mo ng 500,000?
Iba-iba po kasi, Mr.
Marami kang inisyo ng 500,000. Am I correct?
Yes,
di ba?
Yes po.
At saan mo kinuha ang perang yun? Bakit ka nagkaroon ng ganun kalaking pera? Samantala, sumasweldo ka lamang ng 23,000 a month.
Hindi ko po pera, Mr. Chair.
Kaninong pera yun? Saan ang galing? Sino nagbigay? Si Cassandra?
Opo.
At yung mga boss mo, di ba?
Si Mr. Correct. Cassandra, opo.
So sa lahat ng ito, Mr. Chairman, I don't want to explore this issue anymore because I think the right and proper sana po ay sa susunod na. But I think this person is lying eh. Talagang we have proven and those people also, doon sa tinatawag natin sa sila Julian Linsangan, marami, hindi sila umatin ngayon because we will be proving na marami din silang pera sa bangko, Mr. Chairman. And this person, si Ronaline Baterna, have issued a lot of checks, no? At sa kanyang trabaho, sa POGO, saan manggagaling yung perang yun, di ba? And she's trying to tell us that ang kanyang salary is only 23,000. But the reality is, nakakapag-issue siya ng millions of pesos, di ba? And that makes us wonder, why? Kaya kanina, medyo naaawa tayo, even us, the first time I saw her, talaga naaawa kami, single mom, di ba? Babae, ang sweldo, mababa. Pero In all reality, may problem. May problem tayo dito. Dami sila, but they allow to be used by the Chinese people. You were allowed to be used by those people. Diba? So inaamin mo na, Ronaldine, na ginamit ka ng mga Chinese to issue these checks, right?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
At sino yung Chinese na yon?
Si Ms. Cassandra Ong po.
Si Cassandra Ong.
Yes, ayan po, Mr. Chair.
So si Cassandra Ong na ngayon ay nagtatago na hindi natin malaman kung nasaan, and even his her property, no, Mr. Chairman, yung property niya dito sa Porac, may problema tayo sa PNP dahil yung kanyang police order sa kanyang bahay. Wala pong police order. As a matter of fact, si Cassandra Ong can still use her property. Kahit alam natin na galing yun sa Pogo. And that's the reason why the issuance of contempt is just right and proper for her.
One quick question only, Mr. Chair.
Within the agenda of Chairman Dan.
Very quick, Chairman Dan.
Congresswoman Jinky.
Having heard about all the bank accounts, may I know from Ms. Baterna, are you willing to execute a waiver of bank secrecy law?
Naka-close na po yung account, Mr. Chair.
Nonetheless, it is still protected by the bank secrecy law. So the question, Ms. Baterna, ikaw ba handang pumirma ng waiver? Binibigyan mo ng karapatan ang Quadcom na makita lahat ng bank transactions mo. It is answerable by yes or no only.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Mr. Chair, I'm requesting the Quadcom to facilitate the necessary waiver as manifested by Ms. Baterna. And as a follow-up question, Ms. Baterna, ano po ba ang mga bangko ninyo?
China Bank po.
China Bank, what branch?
Angeles, Mr. Chair.
What else?
Yun lang po, Mr. Chair.
One bank only?
Yes po, sa akin, Mr. Chair.
It's quite hard to believe, Ms. Baterna.
Yes
po, kung ikaw magwe-wave, make sure you waive all bank accounts.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
I'm requesting the Quadcom, Mr. Chair, that we facilitate the necessary waiver. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman, in addition to...
Please, okay. Let the Chair make a quick statement with respect to the manifestation of Congresswoman Jinky. So, the Secretariat is directed to coordinate with Ms. Baterna with respect to waiving her right. Giving access for the committee to look into her bank records she is willing to tell all to this committee. Yan lang ba ang bank account mo? China Bank lang?
Oh, Mr. Chair.
Wala ka na ibang bank account?
Dati po meron AUB pero hindi ko nilipat ko na po kasi sa China
okay.
Bank, Mr.
Chair. Sige.
Ms. Ronaldine Baterna, alam mo, sa totoo lang talagang gustong-gusto ko namin tulungan. As a matter of fact, kung tatanungin mo, kasi single mom ka, gusto na namin sana makauwi ka na ngayon. Unfortunately, yung mga ebidensya na nakuha namin leads to the fact that nakapag-issue ka ng mga cheque at si Cassandra Ong nagpadala sa'yo ng malalaking pera. If I may ask you, no, yung Whirlwind Corporation, nagpadala din sa'yo ng malalaking pera doon sa checking account mo?
Mr. Chair, sa totoo niyan, yung mga pumapasok po na pera doon sa checking account ko, hindi ko po alam.
Hindi mo hawak yung account?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair.
So, sino mahawak ng account? Kala ko sasabihin mo lahat. Sabihin mo na lahat para isulungan ka namin.
Kasi po, Mr. Chair, meron po akong sarili, yung savings ko po. Aside po sa savings account na personal ko, meron po akong checking account na parang pina-open lang po. Para so, lalagyan po nila ng pera.
So, ibig mong sabihin, ikaw nag-open ng checking account, pero hindi ikaw may hawak ng checking account. So, in other words, sila nakakakuha, sila nag-withdraw.
Yes po, Mr. Chair. Pinapapirma lang po nila sa akin.
So, in other words, Mr. Chairman, talagang na ginamit siya ng mga Chinese personalities at sila po talagang ginagamit, not only as a incorporator, but as a window for the issuance of checks. And at the same time, yung exit and entry ng mga pera ay nagagamit po yung ating pong mga kapwa Pilipino. We sympathize with you, Ronaldine. But the very fact na talagang mali yung ginawa mo. And yung sana inaasahan namin sa iyo nung last hearing kung nasabi mo ang lahat. Baka meron ka pang gusto sabihin, Ronaldine.
Sana po managot po yung totoong nananagot. Hindi po yung katulad ko na inosente na ginagamit lang po nila.
Ronaldine, kasi ako, naniniwala kami na yung NFC Mirales and Partners, we invited them over. Kasi sinabi nila, na sila, sinabi mo na sila ang kumontak sa'yo, di ba? At si, what's the name of that guy na kumontak sa'yo is from the law firm? Attorney?
Attorney Abby po.
Attorney?
Abby po yung pakilala po sa akin.
And as a matter of fact, Mr. Chairman, yung po yung inimbitahan natin ngayon sa hearing na to, pero hindi po siya dumating. And at the same time, yung may-ari ng law firm, ang pinapupunta natin dito, but somebody from that law firm, ikaw ang nagre-represent. Can you kindly speak on the microphone?
Good afternoon, Your Honor. I'm Attorney Henry O. Araneta. I'm counsel for this special occasion only to Ms. Paterna, Your Honor.
Who's the owner of the NFC?
Yes. NFC is a law firm managed by Attorney Nadine Mirales, Your Honor, the one that wrote a letter to you.
Okay. Sino po ang kumontak sa inyo para bigyan ng legal services si Ronaldine?
Tinawagan po ako kagabi, Your Honor, alas
11. No, what I mean is that sino yung nag-engage sa inyo?
Tinawagan ko ni Attorney Mirales. Sabi niya kasi hindi siya makaka-attend. May hearing kasi siya sa Taytay. Si Attorney Mirales po. So kanina po pagdating, kinausap ko po yung detainee. Okay. Tapos kinonfirm ko po yung mga sinabi niya sa inyo.
Thank you, Attorney. I think what we need is si the owner of the NFC Mirales.
As she knows that I have communicated that she has been named as a resource person.
So hopefully next time she'll be around.
No? I will tell her, Your Honor.
And for us to find out.
We are in a better position to say that, Your Honor, not me.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Attorney
Araneta, Your Honor.
Araneta. Attorney Araneta, no? Meron bang engagement contract si Ms. Ronaldine sa NFC?
Ang pagkaalam ko, wala po, Your Honor. So, parang she just asked to be accompanied sa Senate and dito ng lawyer ng NFC.
Are you doing this pro bono para kay Ronaldine?
Pro hat vice, Your Honor. You can ask her kung for the minute.
Sinong pumili nung law firm na nagre-represent sa'yo?
Sila po yung nag-contact po sa akin, Mr. Chair.
Pakilakas mo lang.
Sila po yung nag-contact sa akin.
Hindi ikaw ang pumili?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair.
Yung boss mo ang pumili?
Hindi ko po alam kung sino po yung kausap nila, Mr. Chair.
Well, okay. Sige, salamat. We need the presence of Attorney Mirales. In the next
yes, Your Honor, we'll inform her.
Thank you.
And also, Mr. Chairman, si Attorney Medina. Now I remember. Ang sinasabi kasi, ang sinabi mo sa amin, Ronaldine, si Attorney Medina.
Yung nag-prepare po ng mga papers na pinapapirma po sa akin.
So yung tumawag sa'yo, di ba? Si Attorney Medina?
Hindi po. Si Attorney Medina po is parang lawyer ng company. Kung saan ko po...
Hindi na, can you kindly remove your ano, para makita namin maganda mong mukha? Ayan, no. So, huwag ka na maya at alam naman namin na nagamit ka lang. So, Attorney Medina yung nasabi mo noong nakaraang hearing.
Yes po, kung saan po ako nagsasign ng mga papers from Lucky South.
But hindi siya kasama doon sa NFC?
Hindi po siya kasama, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, yung Mr. Chairman, yung po yung hinahanap natin si Attorney Medina na ngayon po, according to the COMSEC, ay hindi na matagpuan. So, we'll be asking that we again invite this Attorney Medina.
Okay. Nandito si Medina, Mr. Chairman. Nandito si Attorney Medina.
And Attorney
nandito.
Medina.
Yeah, nandito.
Okay. Ayun. Are you Attorney Medina?
Oh, okay. Ayan, nandito pala yung Attorney Medina. Sabi mo wala.
Mr. Chair. Pwede ba ako magtanong?
O sige, Chairman?
Kasi napag-usapan natin last hearing when we had it na pinirmahan lamang ni Ms. Paterna ang mga papeles. Pero ang gumawa nung pinirmahan niya ay yung mga abogado. Tama ba ako, Ms. Paterna?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Ang tanong ganito, anong relasyon niyo, Attorney Medina, with this attorney? Ano pong relasyon ninyo? Do you belong to the same law office?
No, Your Honor.
Hindi,
Your Honor.
Pero kayo, ang law office ni Cassandra.
Your Honor, for the record po, yung si Ms. Cassandra Lee Ong, ang kanya pong nire-represent sa amin, yung Whirlwind Corporation. Ngayon po, Whirlwind po, Whirlwind.
Kayo ang law office ng Whirlwind?
Hindi po. Ang pong engagement namin sa kanila is magpapareview ng documents at magpapanotaryo lang. Yung pong corporate nila at ano, hindi namin po ginagawa.
Kayo po ba ang gawa ng mga papeles na pinirmahan ni Ms. Paterna?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Okay, kayo po. Kayo po ba ang gumawa ng papeles na pinirmahan ni Ms. Paterna?
Ah, hindi po, Your Honor.
Nag-oath na po ba kayo? Nag-oath na kayo?
Your Honor, hindi po nakapag-oath. Believing that I'm not a resource person. Okay.
Nag-oath na po, Your Honor.
Nag-oath na po kayo.
Yes po, Your Honor.
Pwede ba natin mapag-oath itong si Attorney, ano, para... natin. Pwede ba kayong mag-out?
Yes, Your Honor, but...
Kasi tinatanong kayo rito, kaya mag-out.
Baba.
Sige po.
Okay. Hindi pa ba nag-out? The COMSEC is hereby directed to take the oath, administer the oath of these two resource speakers.
Yes, please.
Mr. Chairman.
Si Ma'am Paterna. And also Ma'am Paterna. Okay, please. Tapos na siya. Please raise your right hand and please answer. Do you swear the truth? Do you swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth in this congressional inquiry? So help you God. Thank you.
Okay. Ngayon, kung hindi kayo ang nag-gumawa ng mga papeles na pinirmahan ni Ms. Paterna, Ms. Paterna, sino pa ang gumawa ng mga papeles na pinirmahan mo?
Kasi Mr. Chair, usually pumupunta ko sa law firm ni Attorney Medina. Doon po ako nagpipirma doon sa logbook. Yung logbook po ng for notary.
Di, ang tanong ko, kung sino ang naganda na mga papeles na pinirmahan mo?
Hindi ko po alam, Mr. Chair, kasi minsan binibigay na lang po nila sa akin.
Para so, sino
po
ang nagbigay sa'yo?
Si Ms. Cassandra Ong po.
Sino
Ms. po? Cassandra Ong po. Cassandra Ong.
Cassandra Ong ang nagbigay sa'yo?
Yes po.
Hindi sinabi sa inyo kung sino ang law office na nagumawa ng papeles?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi law office ninyo?
No, Your Honor. Yun ang if I may explain kung bakit po siya nagpupunta sa amin.
Alam nyo, mukhang mahirap kayong paniwalaan dito. Pakisabi po sa amin, ang law office nyo ba ang gumawa ng mga papeles na pinirmahan ni Ms. Paterna? Law office ninyo? Sapagkat magkaiba ang law office nyo, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Either law office mo o law office niya. Sapagkat hindi kayong magpapakita rito kung hindi kayong abogado, Ms. Paterna. Anong ginagawa nyo rito?
Tama po yun, Your Honor.
Yun.
Your Honor, may respond, Your Honor.
Yes, go ahead.
Mr. Chair, kaya po ako nandito, nagulat nga po ako, nagkaroon ako ng show cause order. Never po ako na-invite in any of your hearings before. At yun po sigurong COMSEC niyo can verify that. Kaya po ako nandito ngayon kasi po binigyan po ako ng show cause order na na-receive ng office namin. Kaya po ako nandito voluntarily para sa akin po, hindi po para kay Ms. Paterna.
Mr. Chair, para magkaliwanagan, hindi ba, Miss Paterna, nung last hearing, pinakita ko sa iyo yung dalawang sublease agreement na pinirmahan mo for and behalf of Lucky South 99. Tama?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Sinabi mo doon sa hearing na yon, pirma mo.
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Tinanong ko sa iyo, sino ang nag-prepare noon? Ang sinagot mo, Attorney Medina.
Yes, tama? Mr. Chair.
Yun ang dahilan, Attorney, kung bakit ka nandito.
Yes, Your Honor. I understand, Your Honor. Pero hindi po ako.
Ngayon, will you answer?
Yeah, I will answer
ikaw bang ang naggumawa ng mga dokumento na yun?
Your Honor, yung pong unang lease contract, which is between...
sublease contract yun.
Yes, Your Honor. Yes. Sublease agreement, Your Honor, na si Nine Stephanie Mascarenhas.
Ikaw ang naggumawa nun?
Ganito po.
Yes or no?
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor. The first,
kasi, first contract. Kasi, nagpipensa ka pa. Thank you, Your Honor. Yun ang katotohanan. Bakit nandito si Atty. Medina? Dahil binanggit ni Ms. Ronaldine yung pangalan niya na siyang tigagawa ng mga dokumento na pinirmahan niya.
Thank you. May katanungan ako sa iyo, Ronaldine. Kanina sinabi mo na yung checking account na nasa pangalan mo na kung saan naglalagay ng malalaking pera si Cassandra Ong ay hindi mo hinahawakan. Kung hindi mo hinahawakan yung checking account na yon, sino may hawak ng checking account na nakapangalan sa iyo?
Si Ms. Cassandra Ong po. Pag may pinapaano lang po siya, yung pinapasulat. Ako po yung nagsusulat.
So lahat ng malalaking pera na nanggagaling sa outside of the Philippines, pumapasok sa checking account na nasa pangalan mo at ang kumukuha nun ay si Cassandra.
Hindi ko po alam, Mr. Chair, kung may pumapasok. Kasi nga po hindi ko po hawak yung account, nung checking account, Mr. Chair.
Kasi alam mo, Rona, tutulungan ka namin talaga dito. Pero may nakikita ako na yung perang nanggagaling kay Cassandra Ong lumilipat sa checking account mo. So ang tanong, sabi mo kanina, hindi ka umahawak ng checking account mo. Hindi si Cassandra may hawak ng checking account mo. Sino?
Miss Cassandra Ong lang po yung nakakausap ko, Mr. Chair. Wala na pong iba.
Siguraduhin mo, Cassandra. Ay, Cassandra. Siguraduhin mo, ano ha?
Yes,
kasi
Mr. Chair.
Kasi we will try to find out. Amblak, andyan ang Amblak. Can you kindly, ano? Kasi I think you are willing to issue a waiver, no? Are you willing to issue a waiver to find out yung trap of your ano, accounts?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Can you kindly help this committee to find out the trace of money between Cassandra Ong and Miss Ronaline Baterinia?
Mr. Chair, if you will already get the waiver that will make the action of AMLAC faster, because if we don't have the waiver, we still need to secure authority from the Court of Appeals to conduct back inquiry. But if Miss Baterna will already issue a waiver, AMLAC can act faster, Mr. Chair.
So again, Ronaldine, you are willing to execute that waiver. Huh? So I will be asking the COMSEC to execute a waiver and for you to sign it. So Mr. Chairman, I think it's really getting late. At nakikita na po natin na medyo kumukulimlim na. And our apology to all the resource speakers who have not been asked by the members of this Quadcom. But rest assured, in the next hearing, we will be prioritizing those resource persons who have not been asked. No? So, Mr. Chairman, I have no further question to our resource person.
Your Honor, it appearing that my client now has already manifested some cooperation.
Mr. Chair.
Reconsideration, be considered, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair.
As regards his content detention.
Chairman, excuse me lang. Let me just reply to his, and then I will recognize.
Eh, wala po nagtatanong sa kanya eh. Subukot lang siya eh.
Kasi yung... okay. I think he's...
Wala po nagtatanong sa kanya. Sumagot lang siya without anyone asking a question to him.
Okay, I think Attorney
Araneta
is offering an information that according to Ms. Ronaline Baterna, she has intimated to attorney that she will tell all. Tama ba? Sasabihin mo na lahat? Tama ba yung sinasabi ni attorney?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Suspension. Okay. Let's discuss it in private.
Okay. Sige, 1 minute suspension.
I'm the one that cited in contempt, no? Moved to cite in contempt, Ms. Baterna. Now, Mr. Chairman, for me, the only way that indeed in the next hearing, Ms. Baterna will cooperate in this committee is for her to execute an affidavit under oath. And we will see if indeed that affidavit will be justified, no? For the contempt order to be lifted, Mr. Chairman. Now, Mr. Chairman, let me proceed with... just an admin matters. Number one, Mr. Chairman, we have issued a show cause order just this morning to the Mayor of Banban, Mayor of Banban, Mayor Leonardo Asunciacion. He is present now. So, Mr. Chairman, with that, I withdraw my motion for a show cause order for the Mayor of Banban. Second, also for Mr. Froilan Cruz, who is also present. Please. Thank you. Now, Mr. Chairman, before I proceed with my last motion, let me just remind Mr. Chairman that this afternoon, Cassandra Ong was cited in contempt in violation of, I think, Section 11 of Paragraph A of our rules. Now, refusal to obey summons without legal excuse. Now, Mr. Chairman, I'd just like to move my second motion for Ms. Cassandra Ong to be detained in the House premises for 30 days. So move, Mr. Chairman.
Second motion.
There is a motion to cite in contempt Cassandra Ong and with the penalty of detention for 30 days in the premises of the House of Representatives. The motion was duly seconded. Any objection? Hearing no objection, the motion is carried.
Lastly, Mr. Chairman, I'd just like to move that this committee will direct PAOK, Sir Yusek, this committee will direct PAOK to coordinate with AMLAC with regards to all the assets, no, asset preservation order in all the assets that was involved in the previous hearings in my committee and the Dangerous Drugs Committee, particularly assets of Willie Ong, Eddie Teyang, Empire 999, Mexico Pampanga, Mexico 999, Yatay Industrial Park, and all other assets outside of Pampanga of those persons that was mentioned and corporation that was mentioned. So move, Mr. Chairman.
There is a motion, duly seconded. Hearing no objection, the motion is approved. You said Gilbert Cruz?
Yes, Your Honor, we'll coordinate with AMLAC, sir. And we will be submitting the report, sir.
Thank you. Since yung pong mga resource persons na hindi po natin na tanong at hindi po natin nakausap, kami po ay humingi ng paumanhin sa committee dahil po may mga developments na nangyari in the middle of this committee hearing. And we do hope that in the next scheduled committee hearing of the Quadcom, we expect that the same resource persons which was invited for today to be present. And you will be advised as to the schedule and the venue of the next Quadcom hearing.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Abante.
I also would like to make a motion that those names mentioned by Mr. Jimmy Guban be invited in the next hearing, Mr. Chair. That would be Small Abilera, Pony Cheng Yatayon, Congressman Pulong Duterte, Attorney Man Castro Papio, Benny Antiporda, Paul Gutierrez, Mr. Chair. And almost all the names mentioned by Mr. Jimmy Guban, Mr. Chair. So I move, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Congressman Rog.
Mr. Chair, just for clarification and manifestation, perhaps that the good Chair Abante would also include the name of Mr. Hernan Abarrio, which was also mentioned in the affidavit, but I believe was not mentioned in the list now. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay, there is a motion to invite the following names stated by Congressman Paduano and Congressman Gutierrez in the next scheduled Quadcom committee hearing. Duly seconded and hearing no objection, the motion, or rather it is the motion by Congressman Abante. Hearing no objection, the motion is approved.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Dago.
I also move to invite the Regional Director of Dole and the Provincial Officer of Dole dito sa region na may investigation tayo sa Pogo, as well as SSS and Pag-ibig, Mr. Chair.
Okay, there is a motion to invite representatives from Dole, SSS,
Pag-ibig,
and Pag-ibig to the next Quadcom committee hearing. Duly seconded and hearing no objection, the motion is approved.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Abante.
Since we cannot think properly anymore because we have been here since 10 o'clock, and we're going to have another hearing. So, Mr. Chair, I move to suspend.
Mr. Chair? Mr. Chair? One last motion, Mr. Chair.
Congressman Gutierrez.
Apologies, Chair Abante. Mr. Chair, I'd also like to move that Mr. Guban be made to reproduce his testimony in the criminal case number RMNL19-03472CR. I would prefer that it be produced by Mr. Guban and that we don't actually exercise our subpoena with the courts. And aside from that, we'd also like to move for Mr. Guban to produce his testimony from his Senate inquiries. That's all, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Is that a motion?
It is a motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion made by Congressman Gutierrez.
Second the motion, Mr. Chair.
Duly seconded. Hearing no objection, the motion is approved.
Mr. Chair, I would like to ask the IAS to submit to us yung all documents pertaining to... Ano ba IAS? Pertaining to the cases that were filed on them since 2015 up to the present. IAS, Yusek? Sige, pakirelay na lang sa kanya. Yusek, can you kindly submit to us all the cases that were filed in your office?
We will submit all of the cases which have been filed as referring to 7,103 cases, Your Honors.
Okay. Since ano?
Starting July 1,
2016 all the way to June 30, 2022, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair, I insist, move to suspend.
There's a motion to suspend the Quadcom committee hearing, duly seconded, hearing no objection. This Quadcom committee hearing is hereby suspended.